Kako postaneš Slovenec? Z Majklom Menskim. Osmi del. Part 8.
Kako se voziš?
Driving in Slovenia. Yeah. For foreigners, it can be one of the hardest things to get used to, especially if you come from a place that has rules. Slovenia has plenty of traffic rules, but they're more like Mad Max-style rules. Besides being scary, driving in Slovenia also raises all kinds of interesting ethical questions, starting with the country's highways. The right lane seems to be reserved for trucks going 90 kilometers an hour, while the left lane seems to be reserved for black BMWs going 170 kilometers an hour. If you want to drive the speed limit, what lane should you be in? Thinking about it will break your brain. A few years ago, the German Automobile Association quizzed drivers in Europe about the rules of driving, and Slovenes finished last, just behind Spain. Slovenian drivers got just 43.4% of the questions right. That means they got most answers wrong. This fascinates me. I mean, if most people don't know about a rule or a law, does it even exist? Driving in Slovenia is almost like a subject for ancient Greek philosophers. I can easily imagine deep Socratic dialogues about it, like this.
Povejte mi, Budalikus, ste že vozili po Sloveniji?
Sem, Sokrat.
Pa mislite, da ste dober voznik?
Mislim, da sem, Sokrat.
In povejte mi, Budalikus, kako vozite?
Predvsem počasi in previdno, Sokrat.
In zakaj vozite tako?
Zato, ker v zakonu o cestnem prometu piše, kako hitro lahko vozim.
Povejte mi, Budalikus, kaj se zgodi, ko vozite počasi in previdno, tako kot ste rekli?
Sokrat, ponavadi imam za mano kolono vozil. Ostali vozniki trobijo, me prehitevajo in mi kažejo sredinec.
Ali lahko torej rečemo, da če voziš tako, kot piše v zakonu, da so ostali vozniki potem jezni, da iz njih izvabiš celo bes?
Tako je, Sokrat.
In lahko tudi rečemo, da večina Slovencev misli, da ste slabi voznik, Budalikus?
Verjetno mislijo, da sem, Sokrat.
Ampak niste rekli, da ste dober voznik. Kako je to mogoče, če pa nenehno jezite druge voznike? In kako lahko rečete, da ste dobri, če večina misli, da ste slabi in vam kažejo sredinec?
Prav imate, Sokrat. Mogoče sem narobe mislil.
Budalo si, Budalikus.
But if driving in Slovenia is a philosophical challenge, then the central, shining, existential problem is the roundabout, what Slovenes call the rondo. There's no more dangerous place in the country. The first time I ever entered one, I knew this is where I'm going to die. Maybe not today, but one day in the future. So far, pure luck has kept me alive. But I still don't know what the right thing to do is. Is it better to follow the rules or to follow the majority? It's another question for Socrates.
Povejte mi, Budalikus, ste že vozili v Sloveniji?
Nismo že to imeli. Veste, da sem.
In ste že vozili v rondoju, Budalikus?
Sem, Sokrat.
Prav in po pravilih?
Da, Sokrat.
In kaj se zgodi?
Drugi hupajo, rdeči so in jezni.
Kaj pa rečejo?
Ne vem, zato ker vozijo in ne slišim.
Ampak lahko po premikanju ust sklepate, kaj vam vpijejo?
Da, Sokrat.
No, in kaj vam vpijejo, Budalikus?
Ponovadi idi ti v p***, ali kaj si ti p***.
In zakaj torej vozite po pravilih?
Zato ker v zakonu tako piše.
Kolikokrat pa vas ta zakon preklinja?
Nikoli, Sokrat.
In kolikokrat je zakon rdeč in jezen?
Nikoli, Sokrat. And that's kind of the underlying riddle to driving here. Sometimes doing the right thing can be more dangerous than doing the wrong thing. You may have the right of way in a roundabout, but what if others don't know that you do? Or if they don't care? Is it worth crashing over?
Povejte mi, Budalikus, ste že vozili v Sloveniji?
Spet to vprašanje. Dovolj imam. Zdaj imam jaz vprašanje za vas.
Prašajte, Budalikus.
Zakaj pa hodite tako počasi?
Zato, ker sem stari filozof, Budalikus.
Bolj hitro hodite.
Ti lahko hodiš samo štric z mano ali za mano.
Idi ti v... Škoda, da nimam hupe. Veš, kako bi zdaj hupal.
In učenec je postal mojster.
How to become a Slovene with Michael Menskij.